Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray to graciously give the whole of this your family, for which our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed, and given up into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Good evening. Tonight's service of Tenebrae is come sort of a tradition here at All Saints over the last several years. The word Tenebrae is Latin for shadow or darkness. And it's an ancient service. It dates back to the 5th century. It's a lot like a funeral service. It's not a happy service. It's like a funeral because, of course, we're remembering the death of Christ on the cross. The happiness comes Sunday. The purpose, though, is to recreate the betrayal and the abandonment and the agony of the events at the end of Jesus' life. And the service is left unfinished because the story isn't over. It isn't over until Easter Day. Tonight we will begin with confession, which is appropriate because it is our sins that took Jesus to the cross. Everything he did for us was out of obedience and love for the Father and for love for us. Then there'll be a series of 7 readings and brief prayers after each reading. And at the end of each of the readings, 2 of the candles will be extinguished and will slowly be moving into darkness, just as he did on that dark night. There'll be songs interspersed throughout as well. And the very last candle to be extinguished will be the Christ candle, because for 3 days the light of Christ was extinguished when he laid in the tomb. The Gospel of Matthew tells us that at the moment of Jesus' death, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from the top to the bottom, and that the earth shook and the rocks split open, and the tombs broke open. And so in recognition of that cataclysmic reaction to the death of our Lord, we're going to make a very loud noise after the Christ candles extinguish. I'm telling you now so you won't be too startled, that it will be a loud, jarring noise. And then we'll just sit in the dark for a while and just sit in that darkness and that reality of what Christ did for us. But it won't stay that way, because after a period of silence, I'll relight the Christ candle. Because as Christians, we do not mourn without hope, because we know the rest of the story. We know the hope of the resurrection that awaits. So, with that word of explanation, we will begin with confession. You can remain seated or kneel if you're able. Desire to have our own way in all things, from unwillingness to listen to others, from resentment of criticism,
Lord, deliver us.
From love of power, from jealousy, from taking pleasure in the weakness of others, from gossip and backbiting,
Lord, deliver us.
From the weakness of indecision, from fear of adventure, from constant fear of what others think of us, from fear of speaking what we know is truth and doing what we know is right.
Lord, deliver us.
From possessiveness about material things and people, from carelessness about the needs of others, from selfish use of time and money, and from all lack of generosity.
Lord, deliver us.
From laziness of conscience, from lack of self-discipline, from failure to persevere, from wallowing in regret and disappointment.
Lord, deliver us.
From failure to be truthful, from pretense and acting a part, from hypocrisy, from all dishonesty with ourselves and with others.
Lord, deliver us.
From impurity in word, in thought, and in action, from failure to respect the bodies and minds of ourselves and others, from any kind of addiction.
Lord, deliver us.
From hatred and anger, from sarcasm, from lack of sensitivity to others, from all failure to love and to forgive.
Lord, deliver us.
From failure to see our sin as an affront to God, from failure to accept the forgiveness he offers.
Lord, deliver us.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Reading from Psalm 40. Let us read it responsibly. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry.
You lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on the rock and gave me a firm place to stand.
He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see and fear the Lord. But they trust in him.
Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, who does not look to the crowd, to those who turn aside to all sides.
Many, Lord my God, are the wonders you have done. The things you plan for us, none can compare with you. Were I to speak and tell of your deeds, they would be too many to declare.
Sacrifice and offering you do not desire. But my ears you have opened, burnt offerings and sin offerings you do not require.
Then I said, here I am, I have come. It is written about me in the scroll.
My desire to do your will, my God, your law is within my heart.
I proclaim your saving acts in the general in a great assembly. I do not seal my lips, Lord, as you know.
I do not hide your righteousness in my heart. I speak of your faithfulness and your saving help. I do not conceal your love and your faithfulness from the great assembly.
Do not withhold your mercy from me, Lord. May your love and faithfulness always protect me.
For troubles without number surround me. My sins have overtaken me, and I cannot sleep.
They are more than the hairs of my head, and my heart fails within me.
Be pleased to save me, Lord. Come quickly, Lord, to help me.
Many, may all those who want to take my life be put to shame and confusion. May all who desire my ruin be turned back in disgrace.
May those who say to me, ah, ah, be appalled at their own shame.
But may all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who long for your saving help always say, the Lord is great.
But as for me, I am poor and needy. May the Lord think of me. You are my help and my deliverer. You are my God. Do not delay.
Let us pray for the Holy Church of Christ throughout the world, for its unity in witness and service, for all bishops and other ministers and people whom they serve, for Neil, our bishop, and all people of this diocese, for all Christians in this community, that God will confirm in faith, increase it in love, preserve it in peace.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Number 160.
I
A reading from Matthew, beginning at chapter 26, verse 17. On the first day of the festival of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Where do you want us to make preparations for you to eat the Passover?" He replied, "Go into the city to a certain man and tell him, 'The teacher says, my appointed time is near. I am going to celebrate the Passover with my disciples at your house.' So the disciples did as Jesus had directed them and prepared the Passover. When the evening came, Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, 'Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me.' They were very sad and began to say to him one after the other, 'Surely you don't mean me, Lord.' Jesus replied, 'The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. But woe to that man who betrays the Son of Man. It would be better for him if he had not been born.' Then Judas, the one who would betray him, said, 'Surely you don't mean me, Rabbi.' Jesus answered, 'You have said so.' The word of the Lord." Let us pray. On the night he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ washed his disciples' feet. We commit ourselves to follow the example of love and service.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus prayed for those who were to believe through their message. We pray for the mission of the church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus commanded them to love, but suffered rejection himself. We pray for the rejected and unloved.
Lord, hear our prayer.
A reading from Matthew chapter 26, starting at verse 36. Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him, and he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little further, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Couldn't you men keep watch with me for 1 hour?" he asked them. "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." He went away a second time and prayed, "My Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." Then he came back. He again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more and prayed the third time, saying the same thing. Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour has come, and the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sinners. Rise,
let us go. Here comes my betrayer. The word of the Lord. Let us pray for all who suffer and are afflicted in body or in mind. For the hungry and the homeless, the destitute and the oppressed. For the sick, the wounded, and the crippled. For those in loneliness, fear, and anguish. For those who face temptation, doubt, and despair. For the sorrowful and bereaved. For prisoners and captives, and those in mortal danger. That God in his mercy will comfort and relieve them and grant them the knowledge of his law and stir up in us the will and patience to minister to their needs. Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious God, the comfort of all who sorrow, the strength of all who suffer. Let the cry of those in misery and need come to you, that they may find your mercy present with them in all their afflictions, and give us, we pray, the strength to serve them for the sake of him who suffered for us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
A reading from Luke 22, verses 47 to 53. While he was still speaking, a crowd came up, and the man who was called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus asked him, "Judas, are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss?" When Jesus' followers saw what was going to happen, they said, "Lord, shall we strike him with our swords?" And one of them struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his right ear. But Jesus answered, "No more of this." And he touched the man's ear and healed him. Then Jesus said to the chief priests, the officers of the temple guard, the elders who had come for him, "Am I leading a rebellion that you have come with swords and clubs? Every day I was with you in the temple courts, and you did not lay a hand on me. But this is your hour when darkness reigns." The word of the Lord. Let us pray. Dearest Lord Jesus, delivered into the hands of the wicked by a kiss, bound like a robber and abandoned by your disciples, have mercy upon us, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dearest Lord Jesus, condemned to death by an unjust council, taken as an evildoer before Pilate, and ridiculed by the wicked Herod, have mercy upon us, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
A reading from Luke 22. We begin at verse 54 through 62. Then seizing him, they led him away and took him into the house of the high priest. Peter followed at a distance. And when some there had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and had sat down together, Peter sat down with them. A servant girl saw him seated there in the firelight. She looked closely at him and said, "This man was with him." But he denied it. "Woman, I don't know him," he said. A little later, someone else saw him and said, "You also are one of them." "Man, I am not," Peter replied. About an hour later, another asserted, "Certainly, this fellow was with him, for he is a Galilean." Peter replied, "Man, I don't know what you're talking about." Just as he was speaking, the rooster crowed. The Lord turned and looked straight at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word the Lord had spoken to him. "Before the rooster crows today, you will disown me three times." And he went outside and wept bitterly. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Let us pray for all who have not received the gospel of Christ, for those who have never heard the word salvation, for those who have lost their faith, for those hardened by sin or indifference, for the contemptuous and the scornful, for those who are enemies of the cross of Christ and persecutors of his disciples, for those who in the name of Christ have persecuted others, that God will open their hearts to the truth and lead them to faith and obedience.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful God, creator of all the peoples of the earth and lover of souls, have compassion on all who do not know you as you are revealed in your Son, Jesus Christ. Let your gospel be preached with grace and power to those who have not heard it. Turn the hearts of those who resist and bring home to your fold those who have gone astray, that there may be one flock under one shepherd, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from Mark, chapter 15, beginning at the first verse. Very early in the morning, the chief priests with the elders, the teachers of the law, and the whole Sanhedrin made their plans. So they bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. "Are you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. "You have said so," Jesus replied. The chief priests accused him of many things. So again Pilate asked him, "Aren't you going to answer? See how many things they are accusing you of?" But Jesus still made no reply, and Pilate was amazed. Now it was the custom at the festival to release a prisoner whom the people requested. A man called Barabbas was in prison with the insurrectionist who had committed murder in the uprising. The crowd came up and asked Pilate to do for them what he usually did. "Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. Knowing it was out of self-interest that the chief priest had handed Jesus over to him. But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have Pilate release Barabbas instead. "What shall I do then with the one you call the king of the Jews?" Pilate asked them. "Crucify him," they shouted. "Why? What crime has he committed?" asked Pilate. But they shouted all the louder, "Crucify him." Wanting to satisfy the crowd, Pilate released Barabbas to them. He had Jesus flogged and handed him over to be crucified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Lord, when we misunderstood, you silently forgave, but we so often respond in anger. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you gave us opportunity to choose Jesus, but for so long we have chosen the rebellion that demanded your death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
reading from Luke 23, beginning at verse 32 through verse 46. Two other men, both criminals, were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him there along with the criminals, one on his right, the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they divided his clothes by casting lots. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he's God's Messiah, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar, and said, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above him which read, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him, "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God," he said, "since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Truly, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, for the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, we pray you to set your passion, cross, and death between your judgment and our souls, now and in the hour of our death. Give mercy and grace to the living, pardon and rest to the dead. To your holy church, peace and concord, and to us sinners, everlasting life and glory. For with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
But